What's up everyone, my name is Nick and welcome back to the channel. For today's review, I received this Windows mini PC from Minix. This one is called the Minix Neo Z300. This one sports their fanless 0 decibels design with high performance running on the Intel 12th generation Alder Lake N300 processor. So without further ado, my review begins after this. Welcome back. In this purchase, you get the Minix Z300 model. You get one VESA mounting bracket and a pack of screws, one HDMI cable, a pair of external antennas, a 12 volts, 4 amps, 48 watts DC automatic switching power supply with an AC range of 100 to 240 volts, 50 to 60 hertz. 3 plug types for the US, EU and UK regions, and a multi-language user manual. So let's take a look at its design. So the Z300 is a heavy metal housing mini PC, weighing approximately 2 pounds due to its large heavy-duty heatsink located at the top for effective 0 decibels fanless heat dissipation. For I/O ports and connecting peripherals, it has two HDMI 2.0 ports with up to 4K 60Hz resolution display. It has 1 Gigabit LAN port, two USB 2.0 ports, and its DC input socket on the side. On the other side, you have the connecting pins for its external antennas. At the front, you have a pair of USB 3.0 ports, one USB Type-C display port, a headphone jack, a micro SD card reader, a power button and LED power light. And to its base, you have 4 rubber feet, screw holes for mounting the included bracket, and if you remove the 4 screws, you gain access to its internal components. Here it shows 16GB of DDR4 Kimtigo RAM module, and its 512 M.2 SSD. Please note, this model does not have any additional M.2 or SATA expandable storage ports. So this mini PC runs on the latest Android 11 Pro Edition, and as usual you have to complete the first Windows boot up wizard by logging into your Wi-Fi and connecting to your Microsoft account. So here I've successfully booted into Windows. And let's first have a look at its basic system and hardware information. So it shows here that the CPU is the Intel Core i3 N300 processor, and it has a base clock speed of 800 MHz. It has 16GB of DDR4 RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. For a more detailed look, here Ada64 Extreme shows that the CPU is the Intel Core i3 N300. And if I head over to the Intel software, it shows that it has 8 cores and 8 threads with a base clock speed of 800 MHz. It also has a boost clock speed of 3.8 GHz as shown here by Ada64 Extreme. It comes with 16GB of 3200 DDR4 SD RAM via a single RAM module. The motherboard itself was produced by Minix and it's called the Neo Z300 and it's built using the Intel Alder Lake chipset. For graphics, its display is powered by the Intel UHD Graphics 128MB integrated graphics and it has a GPU clock speed of 1250MHz with OpenGL 4.6 and Vulkan support API version 1.4. For storage, it comes with an M.2 4C 512GB SSD. Its audio adapter is the Realtek ALC897. Its Wi-Fi adapter is the Intel Wi-Fi 6 AX201, which provides dual band 2.4 GHz plus 5 GHz Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 5.2. So before you proceed, everyone that owns a Windows mini PC, laptop, or even a desktop should always load these extensions found on the Microsoft Store. This will ensure that your PC can play the latest 4K HDR video formats using its default media player. With this mini PC, you have features such as 4K HDR display with a max resolution of 4096 by 2160p up to 60Hz. You get screen rotation to portrait mode, reverse portrait, and reverse landscape. You get a dual 4K 60Hz display via its dual HDMI ports. Unfortunately, its USB Type-C port is not a display port. You can play Netflix in 4K Ultra HD resolution with spatial audio. You don't get Dolby Atmos via the app or the browser. For surround sound audio, when connected to your TV that supports Dolby and DTS audio, as well as your AV receiver, you get formats such as Dolby Atmos, Dolby Digital Plus, DTS HD Master Audio, DTS-X, and Dolby TrueHD. So this is Dolby Atmos.
This is Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio. With powerful moving audio that transcends from channels to moving around you.
Next, you have Dolby Digital Plus.
Whoa! What is this place?
Come on, you guys, let's go!
What captures the full extent?
Do you want to know my secret?
Of nature.
Next, you have DTS HD Master Audio. Next, you have Dolby Surround. This is Dolby TrueHD.
This is the left channel. Next, we have the center channel. Over here is the right channel.
And you have DTS-X. So that covers all the formats. Please note to install the extensions from the Microsoft Store, as well as set your speaker configuration to 7.1 speaker config. For gaming, this mini PC does a pretty good job at playing games on medium to low graphics settings. So this is Race Room Racing Experience. And this is Destiny 2 at 1080p resolution, and you're getting an average of 20 FPS. This is nowhere close to the standard 60Hz for gaming, so you would have to play at lower resolutions or play less graphics intensive games. So to conclude, let's look at some benchmarks and where it ranks on my chart. I'll first start with its RAM transfer speed. The NovaBench app records a RAM transfer speed of 4729 MB per second. Next, its M.2 SSD read and write speeds. So the Kimtigo 512 SSD has a read speed of 3,462 megabytes per second and a write speed of 3,019 megabytes per second. Next, I have the results of its Wi-Fi and Gigabit LAN port speed tests. It shows here that based on my internet speed of 315 megabits per second, its 5 GHz band and its Gigabit LAN port achieved the maximum speed. Its 2.4 GHz band also performed pretty well, averaging around 177 megabits per second. In benchmarking its CPU's single-core and multi-core performance, the Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark produced a score of 1,017 single-core and 3,571 multi-core. In benchmarking its GPU, the 3DMark graphics benchmark produced a Steel Nomad light score of 372 with an average FPS of 30 on Apex Legends and Fortnite. For comprehensive testing, the PCMark 10 benchmark produced a score of 3,141. Here is its web browsing score and its video editing score. These will be added to my rankings chart for comparison. And in the comprehensive AnTuTu benchmark PC version, it produced a score of 427,333. So those are its benchmarks. Let's now see where it ranks on my chart. So I've entered the scores on my mini PC rankings chart, and the new Minix Z300 ranks at position 14 at the time of recording this video. It's also currently priced at $349. So to view this chart to compare all of its features to other boxes in this list, see the link in the description below this video. A word of caution. Due to its heatsink located at the top to effectively dissipate heat, the surface will tend to get hot to the touch, so ensure that it's located where it's well ventilated. In summary, the new Minix Z300 is one of the few mini PCs that generates 0 decibels of noise due to the absence of an internal cooling fan and instead uses a massive heatsink. Even though it may appear to be hot, it has an ideal operating temperature of 57 degrees Celsius, and under intensive activity such as gaming, it can rise into the 80s and peak into the 90s, so be mindful of that. Its overall handling is very smooth. I did not experience any difficulties in transferring files, opening and running basic Windows applications. Its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN speeds are very fast, and once you play a game that it can handle, it runs very smoothly. So viewers, there you have it. This was my review of the Minix Z300 fanless mini PC. If you would like to get your hands on this latest model, it's currently on sale on Amazon at 5% off, so see the link in the description below this video. The link in the description is an affiliate link, and I would like to thank Minix for sending their product for review. So thanks for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy this type of content. Stay connected and see you in the next one.